afternoon, students. Today we are going to see, is HR department a cost center or a profit center? As we all know, the famous quote that is given by Peter F. Drucker, the organization is all about social. It is people. Which means to say that any organization's success purely depends on whether the organization is having capable employees and the talented pool or not. And previously, whenever the HR department used to submit their budget, the companies used to say that it is an indirect benefit that an organization is going to derive. And because of this reason, they used to deny the budget amount that was to be given to the HR departments. But now, there is a transformation. Now, the organizations are relying that people are its assets, people are its capital. And in this process, what they are doing is, they are treating HR as a profit center. And this can be determined with the help of HR wheel. What do we mean by HR wheel? This can be determined with the help of the first step. What is our business strategy? Our business strategy could be the cost effectiveness, or it could be the focus strategy, or it could be even the differentiation strategy, or any other such business strategy which is going to suit to that company's requirements. And once as a company we decide that we want it to be as a business strategy which is relevant with the cost or maybe differential. For example, now we take that the company is going with differentiation strategy. Then in that case, the company should decide what should be its human capital strategy. It should decide what is its human capital strategy. Then what is human capital strategy? It is the sum of total knowledge, skill sets, capabilities that are possessed by the employees within the organization. So because now the company has decided the business strategy to be differential, now the company has to focus on what is the kind of the people it is going to hire and what is the requirement of the knowledge, skill sets and other things that it is going to possess. Once it has formulated the human capital requirement, it is going to have a quality measurement. And this measurement is going to take first step as plan. And the second step to be attract. And the third step to be is going to develop and invest. And then the next step is going to be deployment. Once if you have deployed the people, then you have to engage them. And once if you have engaged, then you have to make them perform. And mere performance is not sufficient. We should even retain. So just a little bit of explanation we are going to see towards each and every component of this wheel. First one is to plan, which means we need to identify the total number of the people that are required for our organization in terms of experience, knowledge, skill sets, capabilities, and other requirements which are going to meet our business strategy. Once we have planned the total number of people whom we require, we are going to go to the next step, that is attract. What do we mean by attracting? This is going to have two important functions of human resource, that is recruitment and selection, which need to be strategic. The strategic recruitment and selection process has to be taken up so that we can have the people who are going to get our business success. Once we have attracted them, mere attraction of the people is not sufficient, but we have to invest and develop. That is, whatever the training and the development needs which an employee requires, we have to provide them so that they are going to become as the investments which are going to give us the returns in future. future. That is what we mean by return on investment. We must get the return out of the money, and before that we should invest. And that investment is going to be done in the form of training and development. Once we have trained the people, then deployment. We say that any company's success depends on placing the right candidate at a right time in a right place. Once we are success in doing it so, then any organization would see its 100% success. So after we have trained and developed the candidates, when we should provide them right placement, where they are going to fit to the right job at the right time. Once we have done this, the immediate step is engagement. The very recent trend of human resource management is we wanted our employees to be engaged, and that engagement has to be a positive engagement, which means the employee should feel the oneness of the organization. They should feel that this is my organization and I am the one who is going to make the success of the organization, and in turn I am going to see my success. So when I feel that, automatically the individual, the group and the organization as a whole is going to see a success. So once we have engaged the people positively, remind, it is positive employee engagement. Once we have done that, then we should give a chance them to perform. Give an openness of thought, openness of communication, freedom of expression and a creative thought process where they can come out with new inventions and innovations, where the people's performance is going to be really contributing to the company's profitability. Once if you are in a position to do that, then automatically the performance of the organization is going to excel, which means the organization is going to find both efficient and effective employment of its resources. Once we have done that, today the biggest challenge of any HR is retention, which means I have done a lot of work in planning the human resources, recruiting, selecting, training and giving them a right place to work and giving them a chance of positive environment, and I have given them a chance to perform. But if I am unable to retain, whatever the money that I have invested on these resources is going to be a mere failure, and our organization becomes like a training institute for my competitor's company. So what I should make is, once I have identified the right kind of the people who are talent enough, I must make sure that I should retain. I should make sure every attempt to retain them so that they will not be going for other options. What is the type of retention that we are talking about? The total number of employees who are going to be continuing their services with the organization. That is what we mean by retaining. This retention should be of all the talented and the required manforce. In case we have done all these elements perfectly, and if we are in a position to take all the decisions strategically, this will result for us in talent. This talent results into a business results, and this business results will generate as profit. The one department which was to be treated as a failure today is being treated as a profit center. That is why today we call HR department as a profit center, but not a cost center. So we have to be very careful that the companies today are really ready to hire you people, provided we have all the knowledge, skill sets that are expected by the companies. Once we have done to get all these things, the companies are really ready to invest us on so much of the money, and the HR department could easily convince the management in getting the best of the people and compensating you the highest of the money and giving them the best of the perquisites and the benefits, whatever we so require. So we have to consider that the companies today are ready. Are we ready for it or not? So today it is an opportunity for us to imbibe in us the knowledge, skill sets, and the competencies, whatever are required by the corporates, so that we can become a profit to the company, and in turn the company is going to see your success. Thank you.